So have you ever had a time in your life where you felt like God was taking things away from you, where he was holding you, challenges or hardships that you went through that you later felt like they refined you? I think a lot of us have experienced things like that in our lives, times or moments where we have where God is somehow chiseling something away from us that he does not intend to be there, so that we might see something greater about who he is. And if you haven't had times like that in your life, I'm sure you will. Because all of us end up having those times where God kind of breaks us down and teaches us new things about himself. And maybe you haven't, maybe you can think of those sort of times. Maybe you can also think of times where you actually prayed for those times to happen. Prayed for God to take something away from you. Prayed for God to take temptations or hardship or sin or habitual habits away from you. And God's promise is that he graciously does that for us. That he graciously hones those things out of our lives to make us more in the likeness of the image of his son. And so Brenden and Bria are going to do a skit for you guys called God's Chisel. And it's about just that. So I'd invite you to sit and listen to that, and sit and listen to the words that they have to say and the kind of scriptural passages that they bring up. And what I would invite you to do is think about what is God chiseling away from your life, or what do you want him to chisel away from your life, and how might he be doing that right now, and how can we be open and receptive to that? So, Brenden and Bria, take it away. God's chisel.
God's workmanship, in essence, his masterpiece. Now, I don't know about you, but when I look in the mirror in the morning, I don't see a masterpiece. Maybe a Picasso, but I want to be a masterpiece. I want to do everything that God has planned for me to do. So I ask God to help me get all the things out of my life that I don't need to be there, to mold me to look more like his son, so that I may be his original masterpiece.
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm God.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. You said the prayer, so here I am. That's how it works.
Okay, if you're God, then make it snow in here.
If I made it snow in here, it'd get pretty yucky, and I wouldn't like that.
Well, if you're God, then what does Lamentations 15:9 say?
Lamentations is a really short book. It only has 5 chapters.
Why is it so short?
I was tired of lamenting. I'm not so much into games. Why are you so into games?
You are God.
What gave it away?
You answered my question with another question.
I did? I do that, don't I? See, I did it again. Alright, step right up.
What are those for?
These are the tools that I'm going to use to make you my original masterpiece.
Alright. Hold on. I thought you were a carpenter.
That's my son. Step right up.
Wait, how do you know what to chisel and what to leave?
I pick out the parts of you that aren't of me, kind of like dead weight.
Speaking of which, if you could chisel just like where I eat, like I've been trying to lose the weight for a while, and I've been working out and watching what I eat. I even tried Pilates, now that was kind of weird. But so if you could just chisel.
Are you gonna talk or can I chisel? Talk, chisel, talk, chisel.
No, you can chisel.
Are you sure? Most of my children like to talk.
No, no, no. Bring on the chisel.
Okay. You have a lot of anger. And some pride. And you compare yourself to others instead of me.
Ow.
You have a problem with greed.
I do not have a problem with greed.
You don't have a problem with greed.
Of course not. I just want what I want when I see your point. How about we just take a little break? I mean, I think I'm doing pretty good right now.
You are doing good. But when you look in the mirror, who do you see?
Well, I see me.
Okay, then we need to keep just, because ultimately you and others need to see me.
Now, okay, don't take this the wrong way, but it's just sometimes when I start to look more like your son, people get a little uncomfortable. Like, even my friends at church are like,
oh, you're holier than thou, why don't you do that?
What you're doing right now is calm. It's called control. You want to control the areas in your life, or do you want me to chisel? Control, chisel, control, chisel.
No, no, you can chisel. But can we chisel where I want to chisel?
That's called control. You've been holding holding on to this for a while. Are you ready?
It hurts.
This hurts me more than it hurts you.
Right. I don't think you understand this kind of pain.
Don't talk to me about pain. I know all about pain. I sent my son to die on the cross for sin and for pain. But it was also for something else. For your freedom. Do you know what insanity is? Insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. There are things in your life, even back in high school, that you keep coming to that do not work. You come to these empty wells in your life when you are sad, when you are lonely, and when you're feeling down, but they do not work.
Well, I was just thinking that...
Yeah, your thoughts are not my thoughts.
Well, we could try a different way.
Your ways are not my ways.
Look, I just can't be good.
You can't be good. I made you good. Be good. What?
God, I've let you down so many times.
You were never holding me up. I hold you up with my righteous, victorious right hand. In this relationship, I hold you up.
Okay, but just be prepared for what you're going to find in here. Because I wake up every day, and I look in the mirror, and I just see this scared little kid who tries to look like an adult and act like an adult, but they can't. So, be prepared.
You have listened to too many voices for far too long that aren't of me. You think you're junk, don't you? You really, really think you're junk. I don't make junk. What does that say about me? How can I show you that my love for you is endless? I know. Reach in your right pocket.
What?
Reach in your right pocket.
Why?
Are you arguing with me? Reach in your right pocket. Yes?
I was just saying, God, I will do that right now.
You were just saying my name in vain.
It's just a name or a saying.
It's more than just a name. It's more than just a saying. It's more than just a bad habit. I want to teach you something about my name. Reach in your right pocket. You know what this is?
It's an old journal page from when I was in high school. How'd you get this?
Hello? Right. Read it.
I love Andrew Holland.
The other son.
Right. I married him.
I was there.
Right. Dear God, today I'm turning everything over to you. I'm not going to hold on to anything anymore. Your word says that you will make me your masterpiece and use me to do great things. I don't see how that's possible, but I want that with all that I am. So please do whatever it takes to make me what you want. I love you, God.
I love you too, Bria. I love you too much to leave you where you're at. I want you to work out every detail of your life. Don't end this salvation that you have. Don't let it be some sentimental gush or some head knowledge. I want you to work out every detail of your life.
But God, it's going to be tough.
I know, it is going to be tough, but you bought the lie thinking that it would be easy when you said yes to me. That's not how it works. I know. I want you to do something. I want you to look out there, and I want you to say, Bria is God's original masterpiece.
Bria?
No, not the way that you see yourself, or the way you fear others see you, but the way I see you.
Bria is God's original masterpiece.
Yes, you are.
And so are you. God doesn't make junk. You are all an original masterpiece.
I think that's awesome. I think that's an awesome word for us today. The reality is that we can go and look in the mirror. We can look in our past. We can look in our own face and see the amount of flaws, the amount of wrongdoings, the amount of transgressions that are in our past that still lie in our hearts now. But God intends to take those out of our lives. God intends to take us from those and make us his own. And that's what he's doing. It's a beautiful promise from the Apostle Paul here. This is from Ephesians 2:10. For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. And if you just think about who wrote that, Paul, the Apostle Paul, The man who persecuted the church, the man who fought against Jesus, the man who committed murder of Christians and sanctioned the persecution and jailing of thousands of Christians throughout the early church. And that's him. That's the guy who's saying that. And he doesn't say, for you are God's workmanship. He says, for me, even a guy like me, even a guy with my past, even a guy who looks in the mirror and sees what he sees, that we are God's workmanship, each one of us, and that God is not leaving us to our own devices, but is taking us from them, making us into the image of his one and only Son. So as we begin our time of offering here now, I would just ask you to, invite you to, not only give your financial offerings, that's a wonderful thing, but also think about, in your own life, what sort of things we might need to turn on the table. What sort of things we want him to chisel away from us. What sort of things we want him to take from us so that we might be made in the image of his Son and grow in the likeness of him. Is that we can go and look in the mirror, we can look in our past, we can look in our own face and see the amount of flaws, the amount of wrongdoings, the amount of transgressions that are in our past that still lie in our hearts now. But God intends to take those out of our lives. God intends to take us from those and make us his own. And that's what he's doing. It's a beautiful promise from the Apostle Paul here. This is from Ephesians 2:10. For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. And if you just think about who wrote that, Paul, the Apostle Paul, the man who persecuted the church, the man who fought against Jesus, the man who committed murder of Christians and sanctioned the persecution and jailing of thousands of Christians throughout the early church. And that's him. That's the guy who's saying that. And he doesn't say, for you are God's workmanship. He says, for me, even a guy like me, even a guy with my past, even a guy who looks in the mirror and sees what he sees, that we are God's workmanship, each one of us, and that God is not leaving us to our own devices, but is taking us from them, making us into the image of his one and only Son. So as we begin our time of offering here now, I would just ask you to, invite you to, not only give your financial offerings, that's a wonderful thing, but also think about, in your own life, what sort of things we might need to turn on the table. What sort of things we want him to chisel away from us. What sort of things we want him to take from us so that we might be made in the image of his Son and grow in the likeness of him.